It's on Mario. I'm going good. I'm kidding. I'm good, guys. But I hope you guys have an amazing holiday, amazing new year. Looking forward to the first ride of the year, yeah. Of course, I'm hoping to be able to vlog that shit this time instead of just making a video. Because all I do is make a video about it. I don't get to actually vlog. But at the same time, that's the whole point of that video, of like those kind of videos, right? To just record the event. But I actually do want to talk to you guys a little bit on that ride. And hopefully I'm able to make it. Hoping to be able to make that event. I haven't been able to make a big ride in a while, so looking forward to this one. But on my way to Two Hands, get some food, probably go to Second Gear. I'm only gonna be there for 2 hours, sadly, because we do close early, which is great. But yeah, 2023 has been a crazy year, very crazy year. I'm hoping next year is better though. There's a lot of stuff I'm hoping to happen to get accomplished. As for the channel, whatever happens to it, happens to it. You know, I upload once a week. I try to give you guys something different than just vlogging or just me running to work. I'm trying to make events, trying to get the bike nights, stuff like that. Trying to expand my content like I was doing before. Like, you guys seen my videos before. I was doing a lot of, going to a lot of bike events, meeting a lot of new people, just trying to really get as much content for you guys as possible. Back then, obviously a lot's changed. A lot of that has been slowed down a lot. So I'm hoping in some kind of way to be able to pick that back up, especially for next year. I hope you guys can just bear with me. I try to upload more. I'm trying to get another bike actually too to put on the channel. I really am trying to, but there's a lot of other things I'm trying to get to first. There's just a lot of stuff that kind of got to get taken care of first before I can do any other stuff. So, yeah, you guys, just try to hang in there with me, guys. I'm really trying. You know, if I was blowing up all early like how some other little vloggers are, so I can make a bunch of money, so I can make this like a good job to do on the side, so I can invest more time into it, then you know I would. But honestly, the time you put into something sometimes is the time you get back. Sometimes there are a lot of people who hardly put any time into anything and they do very well. They make it. And then there are some that work their asses off and nothing happens. So I'm hoping next year comes out to be a great year for things to start happening. But sometimes things don't happen unless you put the time and the work into it. So we'll see. We will definitely see. Oh wow, they're open on a Sunday? Wait. Yeah, Sunday? They're normally closed. Kind of weird. I'm guessing extended hours. Wade Harley. So, I am going to tell you guys this. Even though I don't have a lot of followers, there is something that I'm trying to get done, and that is like sponsorships. You know, and a lot of people that are pretty big, they do sponsorships for, I think, three main reasons. One, save money, because you get free shit, or discounted shit. Two, possibly get paid as well. And then three, to help advertise a good brand that you know does very well for the community, right? So there is one company I do want to sponsor or talk to if they even do sponsoring in general. I'll see if I don't think I'm big enough to honestly even talk to them. But if next year I increase subs, get bigger, get more views, I would definitely look into working with them for sure. The MV group, I'm not sure what we're gonna do next year. I think we got some plans going on, do a little bit more rides, which I think would be great to do a little bit more rides, get more footage of the MV group, help advertise the brand more, get people interested. Yeah, don't get me wrong, MV group is supposed to be like an exclusive type of brand. That's why all their bikes are hella expensive. Exclusivity. That very rare brand, not for how too many people have it, but that's how they make their money, that's how they advertise themselves. So we want more people to know about MV. And to be honest, the more you buy something, the more they're willing to do more, right? The more money they get in their pocket, the more they're willing to push out more models, or even new models or updated models. They can put more money into research and development. Why is my bike so significantly loud? Sounds a lot louder than usual. These are YouTubers that make lots of money off of YouTube. You guys are in charge. Because guess what? Let's say if every one of you guys stop watching a specific famous YouTuber's videos, they're no longer making money. Their career is going bye-bye. And a lot of motovloggers kind of forgot about that. Or I mean, a lot of YouTubers, motovloggers, whatever you want to call people that make money off of YouTube, they kind of got to keep that in mind. That's why a lot of times they do giveaways. That's why a lot of times they say, hey, thank you guys for following or support or doing a support or signing up for the exclusive content like the whole Patreon stuff or whatever theirs is. You guys make the career. You guys get to pick and choose how much money they're gonna make that month.
I gotta make a right.
I had a little tight squeeze. That's the second time I've seen the NSX. He must either work here or he's here to show off his car. But I do my best to try and please everybody. I really do my best. But I'll say I'm gonna give me some food, you guys. I hope you guys enjoy this quick video. I hope you guys enjoy your Christmas, the New Year's, everything. And I hope to see you guys on the road. Ride safe, take care, and I'll see y'all later. Peace out.